Dear students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Deepika Goswami, working as scientist in Food Science and Technology in Food Grains and Oilseeds Processing Division of ICAR, Central Institute of Post-Harvest Engineering and Technology, Ludhiana. You might have came across the baked products and you also like them for their particular and typical texture, that is, some may be spongy, some are crunchy, and they have their different texture. So do you know what are the ingredients which impart the volume rise and give this particular or impart the particular texture to these products? Yes, you are right. You might be thinking of the leavening agents. So friends, here in this module, we will go through the leavening process, which is a very important phenomena during the baking, and what are the different agents through which we achieve this leavening. Among the different leavening agents, the mode, there are mechanical agents, there are biological agents, and there are chemical agents. So in the present module, we will know about the different leavening process. Leavening agents. The word leaven can be tracked through Middle English levain and to the Latin lever, meaning to raise. The process of leavening involves creating and enlarging the gases in dough or batter that expand under the influence of time and heat to increase the overall size of the dough piece before its starch and protein matrix gelatinizes and sets. Any material which brings this process is called leavening agent. It is a desirable process that lightens dough, enhances the volume, texture, eating quality, and often the flavor of the baked foods. Leavening agents. The leavening agents are substances used in doughs and batters for leavening. These agents produce a gas which expands during baking, leave small holes in the baked product, and lightens and soften the finished product. The gas produced may be air incorporated by mechanical means, but usually it is carbon dioxide produced by biological agents or by chemical agents reacting with moisture, heat, acidity, or other triggers. When baked, the porosity translates into the crumb of the finished product. Leavening agents thus contribute significantly to the textural properties of baked products by expanding the batter or dough, sometimes during mixing and always during baking. These also tenderizes the crumb and contributes to the aesthetic enjoyment of the final product by giving it uniform cell structure, bright crumb color, soft texture, and enhanced palatability. There are three types of leavening agents: mechanical, that is mixing, biological, yeast, air and steam, and chemical leavening agents, that is baking soda and baking powder. Now we come to the mechanical leavening agents. Leavening can be achieved mechanically by integrating tiny air bubbles into the mixture using a mixer or whisk. Creaming, a process employed in cookies and biscuit production, is such a process in which incorporation of the air bubbles is achieved by beating fat and sugar crystals together in a mixer. Creamed mixtures are usually further leavened by a chemical leavener like baking soda. Beating of certain liquids like egg white or cream using a whisk is another method of air incorporation employed in the cake manufacture. The air incorporated expands during heating, resulting into raising of the baked products. another type of leavening agents, that is the chemical leavening agents. These are chemical mixtures or compounds that release gases, usually carbon dioxide, when they react with moisture and heat. The gas produced is held by fat pockets, gluten and starch, which makes the baked product to rise. Chemical leavening is used in quick breads, cakes, cookies, etc., where a long biological fermentation is impractical or undesirable. There are various types of chemical leavening agents, but some of the most frequently used include baking soda, baking powder, sodium bicarbonate, potassium bicarbonate, hydrogen peroxide, etc. The amount of leavening agents in formulation has great effect on the final baked product quality. Too much leavening agent will make the bubbles too big, resulting into combination and bursting of these bubbles and hence lending to a flat cake or bread. Too little leavening agent will result in a heavy product with soggy or damp layers. Baking soda, it is also known as sodium bicarbonate. It produces carbon dioxide when it is heated. Upon heating, baking soda releases the carbon dioxide as shown in the picture. Only half of the available carbon dioxide is released for bubble formation in the baked product. The residual sodium carbonate, that is washing soda, can cause a bitter, soapy taste and a yellow color in the baked product. Intake sodium carbonate in such baked product may react with the HCl in the stomach to produce the other half of the available carbon dioxide and may cause flatulence. To prevent the formation of the sodium carbonate, an acid is always included in a recipe that uses baking soda. The acid alters the chemical reaction so that sodium carbonate is not produced. However, precaution is needed to avoid imbalance between the acidic and basic material or the pH in formulation. Some of the acid ingredients that may be used along with baking soda include sour milk, buttermilk, yogurt, vinegar, lemon juice, or cream of tartar. Baking powder comprising of an alkali and acid salt is more frequently used in the baking. Baking powder. Actually, baking powder is a mixture of baking soda, dry acids, and a filler, usually corn starch or calcium carbonate. The acid salt prevents the production of sodium carbonate, which causes bitterness, unpleasant, soapy flavor, as well as a yellowish color in the product. The filler serves following purposes: to keep the baking powder free flowing, to provide bulk, to keep the baking soda and the acid dry so that no reaction occurs while in storage, to help in releasing the standard amount of carbon dioxide. Sometimes powdered and dried egg albumin is also added to baking powder as filler. Egg albumin powder increases the viscosity of the dough, which helps to hold gas bubble in the dough. Hence, the effectiveness of baking powder is increased. Baking powder is a very widely used ingredient in cooking and baking such things as buns, fruit loaves, crumpets, pickles, pastries, cakes, pies, biscuits, etc. Baking powder, when used in the formulation, releases carbon dioxide during baking according to the following equation. Using cream of tartar, also known as potassium bitartrate, in a recipe along with baking soda will produce carbon dioxide by a two-step reaction. In the first step, the cream of tartar and the baking soda reacts, producing sodium potassium tartrate and carbonic acid. In the second step, the carbonic acid is broken down into carbon dioxide and water. The time and rate of gas evolution from baking powder can be regulated by the selection of different baking acids that react faster or slower with sodium bicarbonate. There are three different kinds of baking powder, that is fast acting, slow acting and double acting, which differ in their gas, that is carbon dioxide releasing action. The fast acting, in this the most of carbon dioxide gas released during bench operation. It implies mixing operation and very little gas is released during baking. Slow acting, here little gas is released during bench operation and all the gas is released during baking. Double acting, part of gas during bench operation and remaining of carbon dioxide gas is released in the oven during baking. Among these, double acting baking powder is most widely used by bakers due to its added advantage. A double acting baking powder contains two acids. The first acid dissolves in cold liquid when batter is mixed, then quickly reacts with the baking soda to produce carbon dioxide, which results into increased fluidity of the cake batter. This enables the baker to apportion the batter in molds correctly in weighing operation. The second acid reacts to produce carbon dioxide gas when it is heated, that is during baking. The baking powders are named after the acid ingredient used in the powder. The acid components used in the baking powder formulation are as follows: tartrates, that is monopotassium salt of tartaric acid. Tartaric acid or potassium hydrogen tartrate, it reacts readily at room temperature and is widely used as the fast acting component in double acting baking powder. It is relatively expensive. Phosphates, these are of two types, that is sodium acid pyrophosphate and acid calcium phosphate. A number of sodium acid pyrophosphate powders are available. These react somewhat slower than tartrates at room temperature, but still lose a high percentage of their gas before baking. These react readily at room temperature and is widely used as the fast acting component in double acting baking powders. These are relatively inexpensive when compared with the tartrates. Sulfates, these react readily at high temperature only and hence used as the slow acting component in slow acting baking powders. Ammonium carbonate or bicarbonate, at the baking temperature, carbon dioxide and ammonia is released when we use the ammonium carbonate or ammonium bicarbonate. These are commonly used as leavening agent in biscuits and crackers having a large surface to mass ratio. When these are used, there is no solid left behind after the baking. Neutralization value. The efficiency of the acids used in baking powder can be compared by their neutralizing value. The neutralizing value is defined as the number of parts of the acidic material required to neutralize 100 parts of baking soda, or can be calculated using the equation as shown in the slide. Ammonium carbonate or bicarbonate is used as leavening agent in biscuits and crackers etc. that are to be baked at low moisture. Upon heating, it produces carbon dioxide and ammonia gases and no solid is left behind in this reaction. However, if it is not removed completely, it may impart detectable odors. Hence, its use is limited to the biscuits and crackers which have large surface to mass ratio, and ammonia will be escaped easily at high temperatures. The leavening in bread is achieved by means of baker's yeast, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, or a portion of fermenting sponge which consists of living microbes. Yeast is an oval-shaped, single-celled and colorless fungus that produces carbon dioxide gas through fermentation. It is active in air as well as in absence of air. It grows rapidly in presence of air, but produces more alcohol in absence of air. It is universally distributed, generally growing harmlessly on various plant parts wherever sugar is available. During fermentation, the yeast converts glucose into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide as shown in the picture. During baking, the ethyl alcohol gets evaporated while the carbon dioxide gas, it is entrapped in the gluten film, it causes the product to rise. The optimal temperature for yeast fermentation is 27 degrees centigrade. Baking stops the fermentation process as the high heat kills the yeast. The functions of yeast in bread making can be enlisted as follows: fermentation of the dough, to lighten the dough, to impart characteristic aroma and flavor to the bread. Steam, it comes under the other leavening agents. Water present in the batter also acts as leavening agent when it expands upon heating. To take advantage of this style of leavening, the baking must be done at high enough temperatures to flash the water to steam with a batter that is capable of holding the steam in until set. Cream puffs, popovers and pie crusts are the steam leavened products. Dear students, let us summarize it. The term leavening is derived from leaven, means to raise. It is a desirable process that lightens the dough, enhances the volume, texture and eating quality of the baked product. The leavening agents are substances which produce a gas that expands during baking, resulting into a lighter and soft finished product. These are categorized as mechanical, biological and chemical agents. The mechanical leavening is achieved by means of mixer, the biological by the yeast, and the chemical leavening is done by using baking soda, baking powder, sodium bicarbonate and other agents. The baking powder is of three different activity ways: fast acting, slow acting and double acting, depending on the acid component present.